Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to find the second largest element in an array in C++. So let's get started. So for this, here we will be using two conditions, okay? One is going to be if condition and another one is going to be a else if condition. So just imagine A to be my array, okay? I'm just having an array A and it has some values like 10, 5, let me have 1, let me have 7 and let me have 6, okay? Let this be my array. So at first what we have is that we will have two variables. One is going to be max and another one is going to be the second max. Just I will have it as second. And we will be like initializing both these variable value to A of 0. Okay. So it's going to be A of 0. That is a 0th index, or you can also like initialize it with int min, but anything is fine. Like A of 0, it works the same way, and int min also is fine. So this value will be equal to 1 at first. And okay, first we will be having a for loop. So this for loop will basically iterate from all the elements. So for loop will iterate through I till I less than size, okay, size of the array. So and inside that we will be having a if condition. So in this if condition we will check if A of I is greater than this particular max, okay. That is, we will be just extracting the maximum value from that particular array. So if any element is greater than this maximum value, what we will do is that we will assign A of I to max, because if A of I is greater than max, that is the largest element in the array, right? So we will be storing the largest element in our max variable. So max will be equal to A of I, which is largest value will go inside that, and the second largest value, that is second, okay, that should happen first. So second will be, so this is going to be like second will be equal to max. So do these two things will happen. So inside the if condition we'll be having these two lines. This should come first and this should come next, because max value will be replaced after this line. So the second value, okay, the second most largest element will have the value of max, which previously was the largest element, okay. So if any largest element than max is found, we will assign it to the second largest and max will be the largest. So I hope this made sense. So for example, here we are having 1 at first, right? So after that we are having the value 10. So 10 is greater than max. So what happens is that second equal to max. So max value is 1. So this is going to be 1. And our max is then value is going to be A of I. A of I value is 10. So this is how it works. This condition works fine now. But the issue next thing is that we are having 5 over here. It comes here, A of I is 5. So 5 greater than max. Max value is 10. So this condition is false. But our second max needs to be 5, right? Because second max value has 1 and 5 is like greater than 1. So we need to like replace second max value with 5. I hope that made sense. So for this, we'll be having a else if condition. Else if condition. And in this, what we will do is if AR of I, that is like the alternate condition. If this if fails, it will go to elif. So it's not like another if condition. It's like elif. Else if, to be precise. Greater than second max, we will just store that particular A of I into second max. So we'll just put second max equal to A of I. And in case if you are having any duplicate values, we need to add here an AND condition. So we'll just put an AND condition. If A of I not equal to max. Okay. So this particular program that I'm going to write will also work for duplicate values. If your array has multiple duplicate values, no problem. This code will work fine. So this is it, guys. Just input the array, find its length, have a for loop, use a if and else if. Piece of cake. This program is simply a piece of cake. So now let's just get started. So first let me like initialize my array. So it's going to be int arr equal to. So you can also get input from the user. That's your choice. I will just like hard code the value. So I will just go with 50. 10, 30, 100, and I'll just go with 70 maybe. Yeah, this is fine for now. Later we can change the values. Next thing, we need to find the size of array. So it's going to be int n equal to size of arr. I think we need to import some other header file for size of. So yeah, let's see that in the end. Let's just code first. Let's see if it throws any error. Arr of 0. Yeah, I hope that you know this. We are just dividing the entire array size by individual element size, which will give us the number of elements in the array. Yeah, So next we need to have our variable. So it's going to be int, that is max second. Yeah, this is fine. And as I told you, first we need to initialize them with a value, right? They need to have a value which is going to be a of 0. So here max equal to second equal to AR of 0. Yeah, so this is now fine. And next thing what we did, we are having here a for loop. Yeah, we are having a for loop, and inside that we will be having our if and else if. So it's going to be for int I equal to 0, and it's going to be I less than our size n. It's going to be I plus plus, I plus plus. Alright. And next line is going to be a if condition. So if this if condition is just going to find the maximum value present in our array. So if ARR of I is greater than max, this condition over here, this thing, yeah, greater than max. What did I tell we will be doing? We will be like assigning maximum value to the second max, and we'll be assigning A of I to the maximum variable. So it's going to be second equal to max, and max equal to ARR of I. So we are done with the finding the maximum value now. And next thing what I told you is going to be the else if. So this condition is useful if a particular array element is between the value of maximum and the second max. So as I told you, in this example we had like 5, which was in between maximum 10 and greater than our second max 1 during the second iteration, like second or third iteration. This we got this scenario. So for this particular case we will be having this else if condition, and inside this, as I told you, we'll be having A of I greater than second max. And later I will be also like adding this particular condition, showing you that this program works well even if the code has duplicate values. So it's going to be A of I greater than second, and as I told you, what we did, we just assigned the value second equal to A of I. So it's going to be second equal to A of I. So that's the code, guys. And next thing we'll be just coming outside the for loop. For loop is here. It's going to be cout. I'll go with the second max element is, and I'll just have the variable which is second. Yeah, so I think we may get an error for size of because we are not importing. Let's see, let's just try it out. If it works, it's fine, or else we can add. And after this, I will be adding this and condition, also like adding some duplicate values in the array. So let's just try that also after this particular output. So it's working, no need of anything. So we are getting the second max element is 70. So if I go here in my code, 100 is the maximum and second max is 70. So if you want, like, I can change it. I'll just change this to 85. Yeah, so we need to get the output as 85 now. Compile and running it, and no need of any header file for size of IO stream is enough for that. So second max element is 85. So now this works fine. So what if I add a duplicate? So I'm going with 100. 100 is occurring twice, and if I run it now, we'll be getting the second max as 100 for real. Yeah, we'll be getting second max as 100. See, second max is 100. So for our code to work, even if our array has duplicates, as I told you, we need to have this check, this and condition of A of I not equal to max. This will basically like neglect if our maximum, like maximum occurring value has a duplicate. That's why we are having a check condition as A of I not equal to max. So if max is occurring at 2 or 3 times, this will basically like neglect that thing. It's basic. So yeah, and then it's fine. Like any other thing can have duplicate value, it's not going to affect. Even if our second occurring value, like second occurring element, can also have duplicates, it's not going to matter for us. So only we are like concerned about the maximum value occurring duplicates, because that's going to cause us a trouble, and this particular piece of code like solves that issue. So it's ARR. Okay, so it's ARR of I. Okay, just saving it, and let me just run it. So this time we need to get 85 in the output because we are having 100 occurring twice. Yeah, I'm getting 85. So on final try, let me go with like everything as a duplicate. So this, let this be 70, and let 10, 30, and let my max be 100, like 3 duplicates for the maximum element, and let me have 80 and another 82. So basically, like except 70, everything has duplicate. So we need to get the output as 80 because that's the second max. So I'm running it now. So here you can see right, second max element is 80, which means that this code works for all cases, even if it has some duplicates. So I hope you would have found this video useful, guys. I've also done many other tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python. So do check the playlist as well as Node.js, React.js, grid operations in MongoDB, MySQL using Spring Boot and Node.js. So subscribe me. Thanks for watching.